Yeah? And this should reflect this. But this helps with people who are not interested in reading, if you want to gather people's... You know, you can talk them through as well, you can take them along and say, weigh, you know, what was feedback from the events? I mean here as well. So to see how your event has performed, you can use something like this as well, yeah, to gather feedback. But also, just something, what struck me here is the volunteers and the lack of that you kind of all kind of said. And that's something that you need to think about as well in terms of outcome and impact of your projects. What is it? What outcome does a volunteer get, want to get out of its, his or her involvement in the project or in the project? So if we can kind of move on into the... now, talking about impact and outcomes. Impact and outcomes, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about the theory briefly, are very, very important for a few different reasons. Because they kind of, for what reasons do you think they are very important?
Would you, if your event has a negative impact, then
£3 million, every borough got £9 million, £9 million. and they had to pick their worst economic etc. area to spend that money in. Because of the problems with monitoring and people not necessarily wanting to fill in if they could, it looks so ridiculous, but it works so well. We got these faces with different expressions on, and I think there was 10 faces. So when you turned up, you had to pick your face, and you sat on your jumper or somewhere. And then when you left, well, halfway through, you pick another face, and hopefully it would be a slightly better one. But if not, no. And then you could find out why, and maybe change things for the afternoon. And at the end of the day, and thank God that everybody picked the broad grin when they left. And that, and the lottery loved that. Simple, it doesn't exclude or include anybody, it was for everybody.
Yeah, that's really, really good.
So that's a good idea.
We're brainstorming in a million different ways of gathering people's people's journey, how your event improves their lives and how it makes them feel, and that's basically about outcomes. And yes, very often they need to tie in with a bigger picture, and we should show you as well. But let me just give you a little bit more theory quickly. Question was, impact and outcome are important, and it's important to measure them. It is going to be your ammunition for successful funding bids, yeah, like Catherine said. But what it can also demonstrate that you are really, really serious and you mean business, yeah. Because you will be able, if you're gathering the outcome and impact and you do a proper analysis of it, you will have hard facts and numbers and figures. And that is a really, really important ammunition for stakeholders, for funders, but perhaps also for your volunteers, because you can show them how they actually help improving people's lives, not only their own, but other people's lives as well. And they also can help you to draw more supporters, so you're avoiding the downward spiral, perhaps even attract more funding, and helping to add weight to your causes as well, what you're actually about. So let me just remind you quickly, from a theory point of view, an outcome are the changes and benefits that happen as a result of your event. They can be wanted and sometimes unwanted, or sometimes expected or sometimes unexpected. The important thing is that you kind of get hold of that information, grab a snapshot of it. And for example, an outcome example could be that the event has increased the feeling of community in our area. That would be a very simple one. Both for outcomes and impacts, it's important that you're using words that reflect the change, such as improve, increase, promote, gain, more, better, stronger, less of, reduce, decrease, for the negative ones. And just to tie in with funding very quickly, is, for example, I've pulled up, that's the Tower of, on the Tower of Hamlets Council website, there is a funding application for community projects, and you can secure yourself to £2,500, and the event fund aims to, and that's the outcomes that they want you to produce. So therefore, if you want to get this money, you need to have a name for your event, which is to improve access to the arts-based events, encourage good practice, provide arts activities where few exist, but basically in other words, provide more arts activities, improve the quality of festivals and events in Tower Hamlets, extend the potential of events to develop more audiences, encourage participation, to increase participation, and increase community involvement. And that's the kind of outcomes that you need to be able to verbalise.
Just because that's our city council, it's something that we've looked at. A, the paperwork is huge. Mm. B, it has to go through commissioners now because the council aren't allowed to give out money because town's in special measures. And C, it's an awful lot easier to go to local estate agents and say, what's up your value if you give us £3,000? Rent houses around the park are 1.5-2 million.
Okay, but what's the outcome for the estate agent?
They get an advert.
Yes. So there is still an outcome. The estate agent will only give you money if you draw enough people for them. So there's always an outcome.
There's always an outcome. Yeah. But I don't have to get into contracts and service level agreements. Yeah. It's the Chapman Nigel Little Estate Agents. I send them an invoice, they say they do a funds transfer. It is so much less stress than trying to get £2,500 out of the council, which is the most you can get on that scheme. Where they require, service level agreements, they require to get in. It's bad enough doing temporary debt notices in the contract from the park with guaranteeing you've got to sell cigarettes. The council love paperwork. There's three forms for any given situation. And it's an awful lot easier, certainly if you're fortunate enough to be in an affluent area, or an area that has patches of affluence, to get money out of commercial organisations than it is off the council.
But don't forget that they have an outcome, they want to see something.
They want the pictures and the videos and the tweets, that's certainly true.
Okay, and the impact, now moving from the outcome to the impact, the impact is the long-term effects of a project on a broader scale. So often their effects felt by a wider group of people, beyond perhaps the direct users of the project, and on a broader field, perhaps on government policy. Okay, and perhaps the impact for the estate agent would be that in 6 months' time or 9 months' time, they're going to be selling a lot more properties because their banner has been seen in your park. Yeah.
Only those in the newsletter, they get their money's worth.
Yeah.
For it.
Mm-hmm. So your event makes an impact in their profits.
Oh,
yeah. But coming back to the community, you have really what we're about.
Yeah.
For example, an impact. Could be a county-wide community cohesion has improved as a result of an increase of events in the park. As a result, 25% of event attendees have started to get involved in other activities in the community in the last 12 months. Yeah? And I would really strongly encourage you to kind of do these little exercises. It takes a little while to get your head around outcome and impact and how best to kind of write them down and shape them. But what really helps is reading your kind of local community strategies, perhaps biodiversity strategies or ecological strategies in your areas, and you will find that you can familiarize yourself with the jargon that overall in your area, everybody needs to pull together to make those changes for the better. Yeah.
I think people are very